Andy, I love you so much. And don't worry about me being tempted or anything, because this is one girl that is waiting for her husband. This time with a capital W. What a darn fool I was to have almost thrown away love like yours. I deeply regret it.
The story of Andrew and Helen Del Redno is not unique to World War II. Every day, on both battlefronts, soldiers received Dear John letters from home or found out a spouse had strayed. What makes the story of Vic Del Regno's parents special is that the letters were saved and offer a glimpse at the emotional cost of war.
Mail came in today. 26 bags and not one damn letter for me. And to top it off, some of the boys received packages and letters. Yes, some got 14 to 20 letters. God, how it makes me feel lousy to see everybody around me rejoicing themselves over their mail and me just praying for one letter.
But I can think of nothing worse than being halfway around the world away from home. And now the thing you counted on is the person back home not corresponding. I mean, that's like the end.
Vic Del Regno had to know better the feeling of what it must have been like to be so far from home, fighting in a war on a remote island, clinging to letters sent only infrequently. That's what brought Vic to the South Pacific.
It looks like I'm sure going to Tokyo after all. Now that the conclusion is near and I must once again go over there for my country. Remember the night we made love by the moonlight when I was on leave? Will it always be there? That moon waiting for us? I wonder. Andy.
Someday I know I'll be back again. Please wait till then.